Cześć i czołem, jadę na rozmowę w języku angielskim, a partnerem dzisiejszego odcinka jest aplikacja Cambly, która służy właśnie do nauki języka angielskiego. Jak już mam nadzieję zauważyliście, rozwijam ten zakres mojego kanału i będzie pojawiać się coraz więcej rozmów w języku angielskim. Więc skoro takowe mają się pojawiać, no to wiadomo, że dobrze jest sobie ten język podszkolić. Ja powiedziałbym, że mam dwa problemy. Jeden to jest taki, że potrzebuję szerszego zasobu słów, a drugi jest taki, że czasami zdarza się, że nie zrozumiem idealnie mojego rozmówcy. Już nawet nie z powodu słowa, które użyję, ale na przykład z powodu akcentu, który używa. I do tego świetnie nadaje się właśnie Cambly, bo jest to po prostu aplikacja, która daje Wam możliwość rozmowy z native speakerami. Z native speakerami z różnych krajów, także ludzi o różnych poglądach, również ludzi o różnym akcencie i różnym sposobie używania języka angielskiego, więc to jest świetna sprawa. Można sobie rozmawiać jeden do jednego, można sobie rozmawiać również w grupach. Oczywiście aplikacja jest dostępna 24 godziny na dobę. Dla mnie świetnie się to będzie sprawdzać, przede wszystkim przy jeździe samochodem. No i co? Polecam Wam, żebyście sobie to sprawdzili. Dla osób, które wejdą z mojego opisu, 15 minut jest za darmo, a dla pierwszych 100 osób jest roczny 55% kod rabatowy, więc naprawdę dobra zniżka. Sprawdzajcie to i sprawdzajcie moje przyszłe rozmowy po angielsku. Już się nie mogę doczekać, jak wyjadę do Nowego Jorku. Joey Rogan, bój się, nieważne z jakiego miasta jesteś. Essa. So we are on. Oh, hi, okay, we have a special guest today, a Lil Gnar. Hello.
How is it? How you doing?
And, excuse me, can you introduce
Jeremy?
Yes, I manage Lil Gnar.
TJ, I'm the DJ.
Okay. So we have Lil Gnar and his crew, and we are going through the Warsaw streets, you know, to have a little chat, you know.
Yeah.
Listen, guys, I will tell you the truth, you know. I don't know so much really about you, you know, because they didn't tell me, you know, who can I catch. And I check a lot of artists. I check your music, of course, you know, but I didn't have so much fucking time, you know, to know everything I would like to know. I'm an old school motherfucker, so I don't know all these new rappers, you know. Yes. Excuse me very much, you know, yeah. But it's hard today, you know, like every rapper, so many rappers, you know. Wow. Back in the days, I really knew like every rapper from the States, you know. Mm-hmm. I was selling vinyls, you know, back in the days, and I knew like fucking everybody, you know.
Yeah.
But right now, it's so many people, you know,
yeah,
in the industry. How you feel about the industry right now? That do you feel that it might be harder right now, or it was harder back in the days? You haven't been in back in the days, but how you feel about this competition?
I feel like it was probably harder back in the day because there was no internet. You had to do shit just in the streets, more in real life. You know what I'm saying? Now we blessed with the internet. You got Instagram. You got all these ways to reach your fans all over the world. Like, I could get on my phone and talk to people across the planet over Instagram right now, you know?
Yeah.
So I think it's easier in that aspect, but it might be a little harder in some way because there's so many rappers now. Like you said, because of the internet, there's new rappers popping up
every
second.
Please, you got to close the belt, you know?
Yeah. You gotta be safe, man.
Got this, now it's got just this fucked up song, you know? Bam, bam, pretty boring. Yeah, because it's these two things. Back in the days, it was less competition, but we didn't have these tools which we got right now.
Exactly.
Yo, you've been a skateboarder? You are a skateboarder?
Yeah, I know how to skate. Yeah.
Fuck. How you did come in this? How long you doing this? You know, because skateboarding is something I fucking love, you know?
Yeah. Shit, probably like 10, 15 years. I started doing that shit when I was maybe like 13 or I don't know, like a kid, damn near 14. I don't know. I've been doing that shit probably like 10 years.
Yeah? You're 27 now.
Yeah, just turned 27.
Okay, so you're doing it for some time, and you're still skating.
Sometimes I be so busy now. When I can, yeah, I'll go do it.
What's your best trick?
I like doing like nollie hard flip. Probably my favorite trick. I like doing
nollie hard flip.
Yeah, like.
Yeah, I know.
Smooth, man. Yeah.
You know what I did? You know, kick flip, late shove it.
That's hard.
Man, I was doing this for one fucking year. I was trying to do this. I did it one time, and I was like, okay, I'm done. You know. Yeah, kick flip and shove. You kick, we make a kick flip, then you kick it in, you know, like you shove it in a fucking air, you know, fucking hard. Rodney Millen done the shit like the, for the first time.
And
I was like, what the fuck is that, you know?
Yeah.
Do you remember the times like it was not so obvious for the black people to be in skateboarding?
Yeah, hell yeah. That's kind of how I got my name. Like, I used to be outside, like, and I'm from Atlanta, so people ain't skating that much. So, like, they were like, man, he on that gnarly shit, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'll be on some skate shit, and then, like, I'm cool with niggas, and I'm from the east side, so, like, I'd be around, and be like, oh, he be on that gnarly shit, you know what I'm saying? So, kind of, I got my name, like, Lil Gnar, you know what I mean?
You know, I'm asking about this because there was, do you know the magazine Big Brother?
Yeah, it's like a 1990s like skate thing, right?
Yeah.
The older skate shit.
It was fucking hardcore magazine, you know.
They used to do videos too, DVDs, yeah?
They used to do a lot of stuff, you know. Yeah. Johnny Knoxville comes from this stuff, and they had, back in the day, they had an issue. It was called the Black Issue.
Okay.
And it was, whole issue was for the black skateboarders, you know.
Yeah.
And it was a lot of the background, and also, you know, how they are in skateboarding, and a lot of them was saying that it's not so obvious for us to skateboard, you know.
Yeah.
And so I was kind of surprised, you know, reading this in Poland, because I didn't know too much about this, you know. I've seen a different kind of skateboarding, but they thought it's sometimes it's not so natural sport, you know. I mean, in the meaning that not everybody in the hood is cool with that.
Yeah, I feel like, yeah, for sure, especially more like back in the day. Like now it's a little different. But back in the day, back then, probably, hell yeah, like the 90s and shit, hell yeah, when that was coming out. And then, hey, you got like DZK, started by Stevie Williams, that's my bro. He got like Dirty Ghetto Kid, so he was kind of putting on for the street niggas that was like.
Oh, he got the Dirty Ghetto Kids,
hell yeah, it's a big skate brand.
Started by Stevie. I know this.
Yeah, so he from the hood, he from Philly, you know what I'm saying? He from the street, so, but he really on skate shit too. So I followed him. He kind of my OG on some skate shit, low key. We did a collab, like, we did Dirty Narcotic Kids. We had dropped some stuff, like skateboards and stuff. You know what I'm saying? For like that scene, you know what I mean?
And do you feel like Lil Wayne also makes this sport, this culture, bigger in the black community?
Yeah, of course Wayne did, because to see the greatest rapper, like, a lot of, like, everybody call him the greatest rapper of all time, greatest rapper alive.
The greatest, you know, rapper alive.
So, for somebody like that, who inspires so many people for to pick up skating and really love that shit and really go do that shit, like, he do that shit all the time. My DJ, Money Team, he really cool with Tune, he's cool with Wayne, so they be skating together and stuff, you know what I'm saying? I've actually skated with him in Atlanta. We all skated in Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? So, to see somebody like that, it definitely opened the hood eyes to it, for sure.
You more skate, like, skate parks or street?
Both. I used to skate street more. You know, I'm like kind of popping now, so I don't be like skating, like, it look kind of crazy. I'm just like skating a ledge somewhere, so I'll be at a skate park or something probably. Or like build my own, like in my backyard.
For me, like street skating, it's like, it's a heart of skateboarding, you know?
Of course.
It's a thing, you know? I learned what street is about, you know, because of the street skating, you know. It was a big issue in my life, you know.
Yeah.
And Atlanta, there is a fucking show, Atlanta.
Yeah.
You've seen this?
I seen, I think, an episode or two. It's by Childish Gambino, right?
Don't yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think about this?
I don't think it's really like Atlanta.
No?
Atlanta ain't like that. Yeah,
kurva match.
Yeah,
I fucking love this shit.
It's
know?
A good show. Atlanta ain't nothing like that.
I think it's so fucking special, you know?
It's a good show. It's cinematically, it's amazing. Shout out Donald Glover. Shout out Childish Gambino. believe it, I seen Atlanta ain't really like that too much. Not like the show.
You know, and Childish Gambino is so fucking good actor, you know?
He's amazing, boy. What you mean he the goat? Like, for sure. I think, like, some parts of it is like Atlanta, but some parts is more like for a show type of thing, you feel me?
Yeah, because that's how they changes the feelings in this. You know, some parts are like for the even for the girls, you know, and yeah. The other is like for the guys, you know. And but that's what I like, you know, like how they playing on my on myself, you know. I was really amazed by that. It already finished, I see.
That's amazing. So shout out to what Childish Gambino is doing too for black actors and just people. I think we'll shout out him and Jordan Peele too, they doing big things. Tyler Perry too, just bought BET, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to him.
In how many countries have you been because of the music? Rap shit?
Shit, I've been around the world with rapping. I just did a full tour of Europe 2 months ago, so that was probably like 10, 15 countries. I don't know, I've probably been like 30 countries maybe, 20, 30, something like that. A lot of places, 15, 20, 30.
Did it learn you something? Did it make that some point of view it change maybe even drastically? What way did it change you? Because I'm sure it had to change you.
Yo, it didn't really change me none.
Like, you're the same motherfucker.
Yeah. I love everybody. Like I already loved everybody. So going around the world, I'm just like, people is just people. Everybody people everywhere. You know what I mean? The love sometimes is even stronger where you're not from. Yeah. I learned that. Like sometimes, like motherfuckers go crazier for you, like outside of the state. Sometimes, like they'll go crazy for me in America, but I feel like for people to see me here, they don't even expect to see me over here. So they go crazy, like. I went to my bro's store the other day, 2 days ago. So many people ran up. They like shut the street down. Cops came and shut it down. Like, it was crazy.
Okay. Yeah. And because you've been selling your stuff yesterday?
I wasn't even selling my stuff. I just went there to hang out.
Ah, okay.
It's crazy. Like, what the hell?
And how your brand is going?
Narcotic is going great. I got a new shoe on the way. It's like a foam injected molded runner shoe. I'm dropping in like 2 months. Just a lot of new stuff on the way. I be designing it all myself too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And how you manage production? Because, you know, I know a little bit about clothes business.
Yeah.
And I was running, I'm still running a company, but I had a little break, you know.
Yeah.
But I was running this for 20 years and the production is a big issue, you know, to produce this thing. How you produce them, how you catch the people to produce them.
I got a distribution deal, production facility in LA, you know what I'm saying? My warehouse in LA, narcotic warehouse, we get everything. Most of my stuff is produced in LA and ships out of LA. And then there's certain other things like shoes and like crazy concepts. I'll go overseas, maybe like the Middle East or China or something to do like crazy, crazy items. Most of my stuff is made right in LA and ships out of LA.
But you got, people who just manage this and you don't have to give a shit about this?
I be on their ass. I gotta give a shit. If you don't give a shit, your shit finna get fucked up.
No, but I mean, you know, like, you don't have to go to the production company and talk with the head of this, you know, how to do a denim or whatever. You got the people for that, you know?
I don't have to, but I do.
But you do?
I'm hands-on with everything I do. I'm literally talking to my dude who's doing my shoes right now. Like, I'm handling like the production facility that's doing the foam injection for my shoes. He's in China, so I stay up late because of the time difference. I talk to him for hours about changing the density on the molds and the foam so it don't break down when the wearer gets in the hand. I'm just super on hand with everything I do.
And how you find out producers of this? By Alibaba or what?
Nah, it's like, I can't tell you, that's a secret.
But you had anybody who helped you to come in this business, or you just manage everything by yourself?
I did it all myself, completely alone. Ain't nobody helped me with shit at all. Literally, it's the crazy thing. Nobody helped me with nothing when I started. Everything I learned, I had to Google and learn on YouTube.
Facts.
Everything. Learn how to design stuff, everything. Where to get stuff made. I had to Google it or get on YouTube, just self-taught everything.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
People produce houses by YouTube and they do a close brands right now as well.
Yeah, you can learn. YouTube is crazy. You can learn a lot of stuff on YouTube. You know?
Yeah. You know, I grew up in a times when you If you wanted to know something, yeah. you just had to go to the place or some find somebody who knows
yeah,
and
talk
to him or pay him, you know, yeah. to
send.
Yeah, at the beginning when we was looking for a button to jeans, you know, we yeah. had to go to the fucking fair, you know, to yeah. Just find out a company which produces buttons to for yeah. jeans, you know. And right now you just write buttons to fucking jeans, you know.
Near,
and,
near, yeah, buttons to jeans near yeah. me. Easy.
And that's it, you know. Yeah, so it's
a blessing. Shout out to the internet, Steve Jobs. Shout out to Steve Jobs. Me and him got the same birthday.
Yeah?
The man who made the iPhone, me and him got the same birthday. Yeah, yeah.
How long you've been right now in Poland? You've been a few days or you just checked out everything?
I just got here yesterday.
Wow.
I just flew in.
So what, you didn't see anything?
I saw the city center, I saw my bros pop up, I saw my hotel, and I saw the festival.
Wow. How you like the festival?
I loved it. The energy is crazy. Shout out to Warsaw, shout out to Poland.
It's a second time, as I know.
Yeah, my second time here.
Yeah, and they're really successful with that, you know.
Yeah.
Back in the days, it wasn't so easy to take so much artists from States, but
yeah.
Right now it happens, and it's all good with that.
Yeah.
You're working with Chief Keef. How it happened, how it came to this cooperation?
We did a song maybe a year or two ago called New Bugatti. Me, Sosa, and Ski Mask, the Slump God, I put it together, and then I probably seen Sosa before, like in person here, never, we ain't never really talked. And then when we did the music video, he pulled up, I gave him some narcotic from my brand, we was talking, probably smoked or something, and got kind of like cool from there. And then I was independent, I put that song out independently, and maybe some months later, like, I put my project out that had the song on it. His team hit me up, they like, yo, Sosa's starting a brand new label. We want you to be the very first artist on 43B. Forget everybody, fuck everybody. You know what I'm saying? We want you to be the very first artist. And I'm like, hell yeah. Bro, when I was younger, I'm talking about, bro, my favorite rapper, like favorite artist on earth. So like, hell yeah, it's a go.
It was Chief Keef.
Yeah, for sure.
Huh, he kind of, no, not the kind of, he's like, put drill music on the map.
He the godfather. He made it. He made drill. He the godfather of drill music. Wouldn't be no drill music for Sosa. Wouldn't be nobody. All that ops, smoking on this, thoughts, all this lingo, glow up, everything people say in America or all over the world, it came from him. He popularized that. People weren't knowing that before him. That's what's crazy. Like, the culture changed because of bro. Like, to a huge level that folks don't even really realize if you don't think about it.
Do you know about UK drill?
Yeah, I know about UK drill. I rock with some of the UK drill stuff.
That's a funny thing, you know, like a whole kind of this music, you know, came to the UK and they made it kind of something.
Different. It's different. That's the
yeah.
same thing. It don't even sound the same, but it all started from bro.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be no UK drill if it wasn't for no Sosa, no Chief Keef. That's
yeah.
That's a fact. You feel me?
How would you define drill music? That's kind of important question for me.
Talking about drilling, like building houses, you know, like power tools.
But is a drill music kind of a new gangster music?
I say so, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Because a lot of people just use a drill as a... the sound of the music,
yeah.
But I was thinking it's always connected with this hard street shit, you know. Would you say that it is like that or
yeah,
not?
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of you folk really out here living that stuff, you feel me? Really shit of the folks talking about what's going on around them, or stuff they done did, or stuff they done seen, you know what I mean? That's where it come from.
Real drill shit.
Yeah.
What?
Real drill stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Drill.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, what came from drill, from fucking drill? What's that? Why is it called it like this, you know? He was talking with Sosa about that, you know? Why is it you call it drill, you know? Not a fucking gunfire music or some shit, you know? Drilling, what?
Probably because the fans watching, you can't call it the other thing, you know what I'm saying? You gotta watch out for 12. You don't wanna call it gunfire music.
Yeah. How you see all these different places if you look at the states, you know? You see that the states is a totally different island on the planet Earth. I mean, also about the culture. Do you interest yourself about the rap music from the other countries? Do you know yourself about the artists from the other countries?
A little bit. Like I don't know too much, because I don't even pay attention to too much other rappers beside myself in America. So I don't pay attention to too much other rappers besides
what you pay
overseas. So, but like, I know the ones I know personally, like the ones that I met, and then. If I see stuff in there, like, I got respect for everybody, what everybody doing all over, you feel me?
But you got some artists from Europe you could mention?
Yeah. Who I think is hard in Europe? I think Skepta really hard. Skepta out of London, he really, really hard. Skepta was fucking with me early. I think I dropped like my first or second song. I dropped my first music video called Ride With The Fire in like 2018. Mm-hmm. Blew my mind, that nigga Skepta was on his Instagram story bumping that shit. He posted that shit, tagged me, he was like, Lil Gnar, big guap, big beach, ass shots. That was crazy, I'm like, damn. And I was already knowing who bro was, but yeah, like a lot of people's stuff, you know what I'm saying?
You know Central C from London?
He going crazy.
He had a song. I was talking today with the artist from UK about his song. Like he compared a slang of English slang and slang of American. You know, you've seen this freestyle?
Nah, well,
you gotta check it out.
I should. That motherfucker pretty hard. I don't listen to too much people's music besides myself, but I'll check it out though. You tell me, I'm gonna listen to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You listen mainly just your music.
Most of the time, hey, I listen to me. I listen to Sosa. I like Pluto, Thug, like Future, and Young Thug a lot. Most of what I listen to, for real. Yeah.
Look at this shit. What is going on?
That's not the festival?
I don't know.
That's a different festival?
Maybe it is. Look at that. What the? I will show it to the people, you know, what's going on.
Lista.
Patrzcie na to, ludziska. Okay.
Are we gonna be able to get back? I gotta get back.
You wanna get back?
Yeah, in like.
You borrowed? Was it talk with me?
Nah, no, I gotta go on stage on my bro's set in like 30 minutes.
Okay. So, yo, listen, I will play you some beats. Can you rhyme some shit for my audience?
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, I will look for something which I think might be good for you.
Przesłanek będzie spełniona i już minister może.
If you like it, if you don't like it, I will play another one.
Turn it up. Can you turn up a little bit?
Please go louder.
You want another one?
Yeah. That's a happy beat.
This is a happy. We got one more.
We got a happy beat, and we got a happy people in our happy car, and we go with Lil
Gnar. Let me hear this one.
This shit.
Yeah, I can do it this one. Painted with purple to match my sir. My chopper got titty to match my girl. Niggas say they rip, but I know that they Captain Draco on the truck. You better, I'm a blast. I'm making deposits and clients and jacks. Flashing the gas in the bedroom trash. Your CEO came along with them shopping. They see them out your hand. You gotta say it. Fuck with the bros, you get stressed in the payment. I'm hearing shit up, see the sweat on their face. Call the promoters and tell them to pay me. I hop on the stage and the kid get ready. Now I got a nigga who look like baby. My mouth staying on, known on their face. He talking slick at his neck, he chirp. 2020, I need 28 verse. Shout out to Uzi, I slide with the Uzi. I'm finna go do a drop out the birth. Till I get 24 mil, I ain't chillin'. My Claire Rick on the street and get chilly. Jumping that pussy, I stretch in the killer. Don't be feeling that just how it work. Busting the titties, she dripping like fashion. How about a guinea and skirt in the ass? Red new Vini, don't sound like a dragon. My gutter and slight, man, come on, fashion. Look, this little shit. Man, hold on. Hey. Brands be commas, I finna start bagging. Don't care about Corona, I'm rocking a mat. Louis be monogram all on my bag, and I buy when I'm smoking these shit really potent. Start at the bottom and build me a business. Somebody tell Kanye I make him a big. GI certified diamond got praise. You rocking pussy, you done it the same. I don't touch smoke on the internet. I just drop bag and get into that. Bring me a brain, double our truck. Saw about the fans, saw about the bitch. Yeah, saw about the bitch. Saw about the kicks. Yeah, I drop me some kicks. Nike, try to shoot at a kid. Yeah. I be smoking on Zah, I done in Poland, I'm riding in cars. How about a fest? How about a stage? Cloud my face, cloud my name, smoking on hey, 80K, 80K on the chain, 80K on the chain, beating it right out the frame, fucking your horn on the bed, fucking your right on your mane. None of the face, none of the titties. Slide in the truck, and slide with your bitty. I'm in the Porsche, we ride through the city. Oh my god, and we doing the gritty. Hey. Woo!
Hey. I was on that. Hey, kurwa. Fucking speed rapping, I like it.
My voice gone, I was on stage, but got a little something.
Hey, when you do a concert, you do it with the playback or you do it with the whole voice?
Sometimes I switch back and forth.
Yeah.
Some songs I do playback, some songs I go, like slower songs I go to voice.
Ah, okay.
And like mosh pit songs I would do the playback.
Oh, okay. So the song like that, if you want to dance and everything, you would do it with the playback?
Yeah.
Okay. It's kind of fucking hard to do this,
dip,
you know?
Bro, we hit the body get low. Dip, bro, we hit the body get low. Dip, bro. We hit too many losses, I'm due for the win. Started with social, we flip in the bin. Started at the bottom and built me a bin. Somebody said, how y'all make him a big? Slide on my guy. Driving the 50. Driving the 100. We spinning the bin. We spinning the Porsche. We spinning the bins. I'm from Atlanta. I'm due for the win.
Let's see. Oh, check this shit out. That's for you.
This one?
Yeah, come on. I feel you on this.
We starting the war. I'm out in Poland, I'm feeling real cold. Cause I'm out the walk, I'm rocking the crop, ain't rocking no Crocs, I'm rocking narcotic, yeah. I'm beating the box, slide out the car, smoking out like a cigar. Cut them right down, deal with it, 2 to 3, call it a crocodile, 2. Shoot it at jaw, 2 getting loose, get in my mouth, caught by the 20, yeah. I'm rocking that bitch, I'm blending that way, yeah. I'm fucking that bitch and I play with a pussy. Bring on my gang on the stage. Took with the crack, no bag. I put on ounce with blunt. Zaza, that she got me stuck. All that trick. All that crack and I'm rocking on a sippin'. Yeah, all that trick. All that crack and I'm a real walk hard sippin'. Now that I'm battin', pouring the shit. Throwin' on cash, yeah. Leaving them dead, not by the casket. Ride with the traffic. Ride with the gun, sliding the track. Dropping my phone, I gotta catch it, ayy. I got down and we've been to catch him. I got down and we've been to catch him. Yeah. We've been to catch him. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh my god, we just
fucking around. Yo, for rap, make me drive faster.
Yeah.
How you like the beat?
The beat is hard as hell. I need this. I'm in the song industry for real.
It's a beat of my producer, DJ Pete.
Really?
Yeah.
You need to send me some. You said hard as hell.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But how can I send you this? Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I will take the contact to you.
Yeah, it's my manager right here. We're gonna get in.
The stuff, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you do a shit like this. It's a hot as fucking hell, you know?
Oh, you give me a blunt in like 30 minutes, I'm cooking this shit in real life. You give me a mic blunt, 30 minutes, cooked. It makes hard shit.
Widzicie, kurwa, bit od Pita, kurwa. Studio małpa 100%.com. Wciągać, kurwa. Okay, I wanted to ask you about this thing with the Nike and the shoot, but fuck it, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, we are already...
I'll tell you about it real quick. I dropped a narcotic shoe. Nike said it was like they shoe. They sued me. That Nike sued me. And then it felt crazy to get sued by a company that big. But we settled it, you know what I'm saying? All of the Nike, we settled it amicably, like some business people. And I got some new shoes coming in 2 months.
Okay. And it's cooperation with Nike or it's just...
It's just narcotic.
Ah,
just narcotic shoe. It's super hard though. It's a foam runner. It's foam injected. It's crazy.
Okay.
It's a Skelly runner.
Okay.
Where the interest is right here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ah, okay. Okay. Thank you very much.
My brother. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Anytime.
Thank you.
Shout out to
wait a moment, because I wanted to make this, you know, take a contact to you,
send
you beats, yeah,
and
stuff like that. Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
July
14th. Yeah. PB&J, July 14th. Lil Gnar, Chief Keef, Young Nudie, Tech Ford Everywhere, coming out next Friday. 7:14. It was already out. Just go play it. PB&J.